torn, just in knowing you'll someday see the truth of life.
When the clouds will rage and storms will
Thank you, Lauren and Andrew, for leading us in that song. It's a beautiful song. Those are Mother's words, and those are also God's words to us. Good morning and welcome to another worship webcast here at Cross Life Church. It's good to have all of you here this morning from around the Austin community, around Texas, around our country, and certainly around the world. Welcome, and we're glad you're here. We're celebrating God's gift of motherhood on this Mother's Day. We thank God for moms. We remember our own moms, and we're inspired and encouraged by God's word as he shows moms and all of us his love today. So we're glad that you're here. Kids, pay special attention today. You should go to crosslifepf.org/crosskids, and there you'll find activity pages that you can work on right now during the broadcast this morning. You'll actually need this one. It's questions and called All About My Mom. You'll need this one for the Cross Kids Connection children's message later. So go download those activity pages, print them out. And I printed out that one. And then there's this is a special one that has different mothers of the Bible in it. I even colored that a little bit. Isn't that kind of nice? You can probably color better than I can. So crosslifepf.org/crosskids with a Z. Download those pages, get the kids coloring. They'll need that for later in the broadcast as we're giving special gifts from the kids to moms today. Also, we please ask if you're joining us today to fill out a connection card online. A connection card lets us know that you're here, especially Cross Life members. We want to know that you're out there. If you're a guest today, we certainly want to know who you are. So go to crosslifepf.org/connection card. to submit your connection cards online. With that connection card, you can give us prayer requests for your prayer needs. We have an active prayer team. We love taking your prayers to God, and we use those for our prayer material in our crosstalk at the conclusion of the service. We also offer you the opportunity to give and support our ministry as we continue this online ministry and get it known even to bigger parts of the world. You can go to crosslifepf.org/give. to support this ministry. With that, I want to begin our worship for this Mother's Day as we continue the series called Tomorrowland, Facing a Future Without Fear. Moms don't need to be afraid. Moms can have courage doing their jobs, and the rest of us can support them. Let's start with prayer. Good morning, Lord. This is the day that you have made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Your mercies are new every morning, and in our worship today, we call on your mercy, your life-giving promises, and your forgiveness through the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. God, you have given our world the gift of motherhood and given us each a mother and made some who are worshiping with us today to be mothers too. You also, in love, bless some women in ways other than being a mother and provide care for those divorced or surviving their own children or husbands in death. You make single women whole in Jesus Christ, and you bless families to be the foundational group of our society. God, lavish us with your love in our worship today. Thank you for this technology which allows us to be online and for all who have gathered. We now join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. For moms and families looking for guidance during the coronavirus, for all of us seeking answers and certainly wanting God's truth to replace fear, let's sing together now this beautiful song, "Oh, that the Lord would guide my ways." Even though all their roles might look different, all mothers play an important role in the generations to come. We have a biblical video for you now to show you women of the Bible so that it inspires and encourages moms and all of us to appreciate God's gift of motherhood.
Mm-hmm. Motherhood plays an important role in the Bible. It binds the beginning and the end. These stories offer us a glimpse into the heart of God. And so we start at the beginning. Taken from the side of Adam, gifted with bringing forth life, the first woman was named Eve because she was the mother of all living. But she was also a mother in her own right, the first of many mothers to come. Though Sarah's womb was closed, God promised nations and kings would come from her. 10 years pass, and motherhood seems as impossible as the day it was promised. But the Lord is faithful to keep his promises, and Sarah bore a son who made her laugh. Leah was the firstborn, overlooked by her husband Jacob, who gave his heart to her younger sister. When the Lord saw that Leah was hated, he opened her womb. Despite Jacob's disdain, she found her motherhood in the Lord. When Pharaoh became angry at the fruitfulness of the Hebrews, Jochebed sacrificed her motherhood for the sake of her son. When Pharaoh's daughter saw the child, she had compassion on him. Because of Jochebed's sacrificial motherhood, the Israelites found freedom. Naomi was a mother who experienced the loss of her sons, yet she gained a daughter in Ruth who declared, "For where you go, I will go. Your people will be my people. Your God, my God." Naomi and Ruth became family by faith. Mary, a virgin and not yet married, was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. The motherhood of this blessed woman was more than the continuation of a family name, but a means for God to bring a Savior into the world to save his people from their sins. From the garden to the cross, there have always been mothers. These women paved the way for all women, representing the full spectrum of the ways one could be called mom. Whether a mother in faith, mentorship, adoption, or by birth, you play an important role in the stories of generations to come. To all the Sarahs, Leahs, Jochebeds, and Naomis, happy Mother's Day.
Wasn't that an amazing video depicting mothers of the Bible? And there's certainly more mothers. Well, there's certainly more mothers. There's mothers here today. There's our mothers. At CrossLife, we are putting together a mosaic of moms, and we need your help. Can you please send us a picture? If you are worshiping as a family today and mom's in the house, just take a family selfie, or dad, you can take a picture of mom with the kids and send it to us via email. Send it to hello@crosslifepf.org. Or if you're not with your family or not with each other, send us a picture of you and your mom. Or if you're a mother and you're not with your kids, send us a picture of you with your kids. You don't have to take it today. It can be an older picture. We're just looking for pictures with moms in them, and we're going to make a mosaic of moms and share that with anyone who contributes. Send your pictures, please, to hello@crosslifepf.org. We're also going to give you a minute or two to complete your connection card. You find that at crosslifepf.org/connection card. These are very important. We're receiving some regularly, but not from 100% of those who are viewing. We'd love to know that you're out there, especially CrossLife members, so that we know that you're connecting and everything's okay. So please fill out that connection card. We'll also give you a moment to give if you'd like to support our ministry and making the message of Jesus known through these broadcasts. You can go to crosslifepf.org/give. We'll be back in a minute.
Thank you.
Welcome, CrossLifers, and good morning again on this special Mother's Day celebration as we acknowledge motherhood and thank God for it. Amazingly, this is a part of our series, Facing a Future Without Fear, and we want moms to not be afraid, to be themselves, and to fulfill their God-given calling. Listen to these words right here in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, beginning at verse 6. They fit right into our series, and the Apostle Paul mentions mothers. Beginning at verse 6, 1 Thessalonians chapter 2. Paul is again writing on behalf of himself and Silas and Timothy, the apostles, and he says this, "We were not looking for praise from people, not from you or anyone else, even though as apostles of Christ we could have asserted our authority. Instead, we were gentle among you. Just as a nursing mother cares for her children, so we cared for you. Because we loved you so much, we were delighted to share with you not only the gospel of God, but our lives as well. Surely you remember, brothers and sisters, our toil and hardship. We worked night and day in order not to be a burden to anyone while we preached the gospel of God to you." So what if appreciation and praise and thanks was the currency that mothers needed in order to operate, kind of like a vending machine? The coins of appreciation and thanks and praise needed to clink down inside mom in order for her to do her job as a mom. "Thanks, Mom, for handling my dirty socks and underwear and for lovingly separating lights and darks and for putting it in the washing machine in water that's just the right temperature and for remembering to take it out of the washing machine and put it into the dryer and then at the right time pulling it out of the dryer and folding it just right and giving it back to me like it's brand new and it smells so clean and new. Thanks, Mom. You're the best. Cha-ching! Mom does laundry for another day. Thanks, Mom, for cleaning up my crumbs on the table after I ate my peanut butter sandwich. Mom, you're the best. Cha-ching! Mom cleans the kitchen for another day. Thanks, honey, for getting up in the middle of the night with the baby every night. And thanks for planning our meals and paying the bills. Oh, thanks, honey. You're amazing. You're beautiful. Our children are going to have a bright future because of you. Honey, can I give you a foot rub or take you out to dinner or wash your car? Cha-ching! What if moms were looking for praise from people? That's what I just read in verse 6. Looking for praise from people every day, like the kind of praise that moms get on Mother's Day. Well, I think they'd be disappointed. Because I think moms are underappreciated. Now, what if moms, being underappreciated, developed a little bit of a spirit of discouragement and disappointment? Because they aren't given the praise and the recognition that they truly deserve. And then what if that spirit of disappointment and discouragement grows into just some low-level simmering bitterness. And that bitterness takes root. And then that the root of bitterness develops shoots of impatience and irritability. And what if mom, not getting the recognition and appreciation that she deserves and that she desires, and all of this happens, and she grows to be impatient and irritable. She starts snapping at the children. She starts nagging at her husband because he's behaving childish like one of the kids, for Pete's sake. And she uses her mom assertive voice with her mom authority, and she finds herself saying all the time, "Be quiet, clean up. Do you want me to count to three? One, two." First Thessalonians 2, verse 6. She is looking for praise from people and she's not being paid the currency that she deserves. I get it. She's not getting paid that. And so mom becomes a mercenary. She has replaced her delight and her passion for motherhood with duty and professionalism. She's like an independent contractor, not getting paid enough money. Now, this is real, and this can happen over a day, over a decade, or even in a few minutes. It's very real. As a matter of fact, it's mentioned in the Bible. The very thing that I just described is mentioned in Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 56, which says, "The most gentle and sensitive woman among you will begrudge the husband she loves and her own son or daughter." Today, the Apostle Paul compares pastoring these Thessalonian Christians, these believers. He compares that with a mother parenting her child. It's as if the Apostle Paul is writing a Mother's Day card. I mean, these words are, I can't believe I haven't preached on these ever in my ministry on Mother's Day, but here they are, 1 Thessalonians 2, verses 6 through 8. "We were not looking for praise from people, not from you or anyone else, even though as apostles of Christ, we could have asserted our authority. Instead, we were gentle among you, just as a nursing mother cares for her children, so we cared for you." Moms, I want to take you back, if I can right now. I want to take you back to the blood, sweat, and tears of the delivery room. Can I do that? You know that moment when you had your baby and things maybe happened and escalated faster than you anticipated, and all of a sudden you were the focus of attention in a heartbeat, and the medical team, the doctors and nurses, they were looking at you and they had expectations of you, and you were supposed to breathe a certain way, and you were supposed to remain calm, and you were supposed to not be in too much pain, but tell them if you're in too much pain, and you were supposed to push like this bowling ball sized thing out of you, or maybe you were quick rushed to an emergency C-section, and it all happened so fast, or maybe not fast enough, and you're in labor for 24 hours, and that was painful, but finally, at the end of it all, the baby is delivered, and your baby, your precious little baby, comes out screaming his or her disapproval, like you did something wrong, crying. And it's tense, and you haven't caught your breath yet, and you're wondering, is this supposed to be this not romantic? Because I was really hoping it would just be nice and calm and serene. And the nurse takes your baby and puts your baby on your chest, skin to skin. And your baby goes from crying to cooing. And you can hear your baby breathe. And your baby can hear your heartbeat and hear you breathe too. And you rub your baby's head, your baby kind of nuzzles in, and it's this moment of gentle intimacy. As far as you know, there's nothing else going on in the world right now, nothing except this. That is how the Apostle Paul describes the love and care that he and the other apostles gave to the Thessalonians, but it's more than that here. That's how the Bible describes God's gentle intimacy and love and affection for you. All right, so we have it right here in Isaiah 49, verse 15. God once promised it this way. "Can a mother forget the baby at her breast and have no compassion on the child she has born? Though she may forget, I will not forget you." That's a promise from God. He says, "I will not underappreciate you, moms. I will not neglect you, woman who cannot bear children. I will not leave you broken, mom who miscarried. I will not leave you alone, single mom, widow, divorced mom. I will appreciate you. I will recognize you. I will have compassion on you. I will be there. I will be engaged and involved in you and in your family. God says, I will not forget you. So moms, women, wives, mother figures, God loves you. He loves you with that passion, with that gentle intimacy that you saw and perhaps even have experienced with your own child. God loves you so much that he gives you his life. What is that? God the Father gave you his one and only Son who gave up his life for you. And then the Holy Spirit has given you new life in your baptism, and you've been born again spiritually. And God the Father embraces you with his arms and says, everything's going to be okay. I love you. You are mine. I will not forget you. That word that the Apostle Paul used here about care, the care that he and the apostles give to the Thessalonians, very special word. It really means to cherish and to comfort. And interestingly, it's the same word that by verbal inspiration Paul uses in Ephesians 5 when he said that Christ cares for the church, for all believers. Christ cherishes and comforts all believers. All right, kids, I need you to do me a favor now, kids. I'm going to help you give a special Mother's Day gift to your mom, but I need you to help me a little bit and just go with me here. Okay, trust me, it's going to be good. But here's what I need you to do, kids. I need you to put your thinking cap on, and I need you to remember something recently. And what I need you to remember, kids, when was the last time you did something naughty or wrong that made mom upset? Maybe it was this morning. Maybe it was yesterday, this past week. Maybe it was a while back. I need you to think of that. And then, kids, if your mom is there in the room with you, I need you to go to your mom and say, when you think of what you've done wrong and made mom upset, okay? You go to mom right now and say, Mom, I'm sorry for, and you tell her what you're sorry for, and then ask, will you forgive me? Okay, do that right now. Mom, I'm sorry for, will you forgive me? Moms, how do you respond to that? What do you do when your child comes to you and says that? Of course you say, yes, I forgive you. And you might linger with a hug. You might hug them even tighter than they're hugging you. Yes, I forgive you. Okay, moms, now listen. Let your kids go for a second. Kids, good job. Thank you. You just gave your moms a Mother's Day gift. And it's not just you saying you're sorry, but it's this right here. Moms, this is what God does to you. This is what he is saying right now. He's saying that he loves you, that he appreciates you, that he forgives you. He cares for you so much. He loves you so much. Moms, mother figures, women, wives. He does not forget you. He gently cares for you. He soothes and comforts you. So, verse 9 says something, and I want to end this way, all right? Moms, mother figures, wives, women, everyone who's listening, I want to end this way. You might say to your children, like the Apostle Paul says here in verse 9, surely you remember our toil and hardship. We worked night and day not to be a burden to anyone while we preached the gospel of God to you. Did you hear that, moms? You hear that? As you work hard, night and day, as you're toiling and striving, as you're doing the laundry and cleaning the kitchen and planning meals and taking kids on errands and figuring out how to help them with their homework at home and living through a quarantine, moms, as you're working night and day, your toil and hardship, you're preaching. You are preaching the gospel of God, dear kids, mom. As a Christian mom with faith in God, you are preaching to your kids. So, moms, give to your family what God first gives to you. That's how to be a mom. And you don't need to be paid. You don't need to be a mercenary or not an independent contractor. You don't need coins going into you. Just give to your family what God first gives to you. Give them the compassion and care that God has given to you. Give them the comfort and the soothing that God has already given to you. Give them the forgiveness that God has already given to you. Give them especially appreciation. Because moms, God truly appreciates you. Amen. Let's pray. Dear God, what a powerful message for moms, and not just powerful, but gentle too. Encouraging, heartwarming, even intimate, God, as you make promises here about all believers receiving your grace through the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ and the ministry of the Holy Spirit, and especially moms, wives, women, mother figures, receiving your grace and favor too. God, thank you for helping us to appreciate our mothers today. Help us as a society to hold women and mothers up, to appreciate the divine calling that you have given to moms and the beauty that you have given to them and to their families. Bless moms today too, God. Bless them and help them be courageous in you, be confident in the calling that you've given them, and to appreciate your appreciation for them so it leads them to appreciate their calling all the time. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Kids, I have another gift that I'm going to help you give to your moms. So stay right there and get ready for the Cross Kids Connection Children's Message. Welcome to this week's Cross Kids Connection Children's Message. Kids, this is just for you. Moms, dads, you can take a little break if you want. Just a reminder, moms and dads, we're looking for pictures of your family or of you and your mom in some way. If you need to find those pictures now, you can put your kids in front of the screen and go find those pictures, because I want to talk to you kids. Kids, do you have this yet? Did you print this out earlier? I hope you do, because I need you to use it to take some notes. I already filled mine out all about my mom. I just need a picture in there yet, but I filled out everything else for my mom. I want you to have this and something to write, because I want to have you take notes about three praises for mom today. I'm going to show you what they are right on this chart. Three praises for mom. And I want you to write down these three words on your All About Mom sheet. These three words are the three praises: care, cheer, and Christian. See, mom loves being praised, and so we want to praise her, not just on Mother's Day, but on every day. How do we praise her? With three C's. We help mom see. Get it? Three C's. Care. So can you care for mom? Hey, mom, how about if I do the dishes today? Hey, mom, can I clean up after the dog today? You're caring for mom. You want to cheer for mom. Yay, go mom. Mom, you're the best driver in the world. Mom, you look beautiful today. Mom, I really appreciate how you take care of me. Cheer for mom. And finally, the third C, write these words down, kids, if you can. The third C, Christian. Be a Christian just like your mom. Pray like her, read the Bible like her, and come to church like her. When we get back here again on Sunday mornings in this church, get up on time with mom and come on, be here and worship God. Care, cheer, and Christian, the three C's of praise for mom. Why? Because in this verse, Proverbs 31, we read, "Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised." Let's praise our moms, kids. Care for mom, cheer for mom, and be a Christian like mom. Let's pray. Thank you, God, for our moms. Help us to care for them, to cheer for them, and to be a Christian like them. God, may our moms be encouraged and appreciated today and always. And all God's people said, amen. Let's continue with this beautiful song. It encourages us when we live in a time of fear to not listen to fear, but instead to listen to God's truth.
When he told you you're not good enough, when he told you you're not right, when he told you you're not strong enough to put up a good fight, when he told you you're not worthy, when he told you you're not loved, when he told you you're not beautiful, you'll never be enough. He will take your breath, stop you in your steps. Fear, he is a liar. He will rob your rest, steal your happiness, cast your fear in the fire, 'cause fear, he is a liar. When he told you you were troubled, you'd forever be alone. When he told you you should run away, you'll never find a home. When he told you you were dirty, should be ashamed. When he told you you could be the one that grace could never change. Oh, he is a liar. He will take your breath, stop you in your steps. Fear, he is a liar. He will
liar.
Thank you, Andrew, for that song. What a great song as we address fear with faith and we continue to lead our fears. Please join us for the conclusion of our worship broadcast today. We continue on Facebook Live with Crosstalk, an interactive Q&A. I will be looking for your questions, your answers, and give you more about some of the scripture that we had in 1 Thessalonians and about a special plaque I'm wondering if you would put on your desk. You can join us Facebook Live at Cross Life PF Church. We look forward to seeing you there. Don't go anywhere, and we'll see you in a minute.